Hymn, which will be sung by Karen blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Also with you.
Solomon assembled the elders of Israel and all the heads of the tribes, the leaders of the ancestral houses of the Israelites, before King Solomon in Jerusalem, to bring up the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord out of the city of David, which is Zion. Then the priests brought the Ark of the Covenant to underneath the wings of the to the inner sanctuary of the house in the most holy place underneath the wings of the cherubim. Excuse me. And when the priest came out of the holy place, a cloud filled the house of the Lord, so that the priest could not stand to minister because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord. Then Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of all the assembly of Israel and spread out his hands to heaven and said, O Lord God of Israel, there is no God like you in heaven above or on the earth beneath, keeping covenant and steadfast love for your servants who walk before you with all their heart. The covenant that you kept for your servant, my father David, as you declared to him, you promised with your mouth and have this day fulfilled with your hand. pray toward this place, O here in heaven, your dwelling place, heed and forgive. Likewise, when a foreigner who is not of your people Israel comes from a distant land because of your name, where they shall hear of your great name, your mighty hand, and your outstretched arm. When a foreigner comes and prays toward this house, then hear in heaven your dwelling place, and do according to all that the foreigner calls to you, so that all the peoples of the earth may know your name and fear you, as to the people, your people Israel, and so that they may know that your name has been invoked on the house that I have built. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray Psalm 84, breaking at the asterisk. How dear to me is your dwelling, O Lord of hosts.
My soul has a desire and longing for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh rejoice in the living God.
The sparrow has found her a house, and the swallow a nest where she may lay her young.
By the side of your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
Happy are they who dwell in your house.
They will always be praising you.
Happy are the people whose strength is in you,
whose hearts are set on the pilgrim's way.
Those who go through the desolate valley will find it a place of springs.
For the early rains have covered it with pools of water.
They will climb from height to height.
And the God of gods will reveal himself in Zion.
Lord God of hosts, hear my prayer.
Hearken, O God of Jacob.
Behold our defenders, O God.
And look upon the face of your anointed.
For one day your courts is better than a thousand in my own room.
And to stand at the threshold of the house of my God, than to dwell in the tents of the wicked.
The Lord God is both sun and shield.
He will give grace and glory.
No good thing will the Lord withhold
from those who walk with integrity.
O Lord of hosts,
happy are they who put their trust in you.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Ephesians. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of the present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and having done everything, will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all these, take the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always persevere in supplication for the saints. Pray also to me, for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to you, to me, to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly as I must speak. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christ.
Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in him, said Jesus. And just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which our ancestors ate till they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever. And he said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. And when many of his disciples heard it,
it is seen in us. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen. The prayers of the people are formed two, which is found on page 9 of the bulletin. I ask your prayers for God's people throughout the world, for the Most Reverend Justin Welby, Archbishop of Canterbury, for the Most Reverend Michael Curry, our presiding bishop, and for the Right Reverend Eugene Sutton, our bishop, for the Right Reverend Robert Eloff, our assisting bishop, and for our rector, Reverend Elizabeth Cyprus, for the wardens, vestry, staff, and all members and friends of St. John's Church, for this gathering, and for all members and people who pray for the church. I ask your prayers for peace, for goodwill among nations, for this community, the nation, and the world, especially for Joseph, our president, for Larry, our governor, for Brandon, Nick, John, and Barry, who lead our city and counties, and for the well-being of all people. Pray for justice and peace. I ask your prayers for the poor, the sick, the hungry, the oppressed, and those in prison. Pray for those in any need or trouble. I ask your prayers for all who seek God or a deeper knowledge of Him. Pray that they may find and be found by Him. I ask your prayers for the departed. Pray for those who have died.
For Michael.
Almighty God, by your Holy Spirit, you have made us one with your saints in heaven and on earth. Grant that in that earthly pilgrimage we may always be supported by this fellowship of love and prayer, and know ourselves to be surrounded by their witness to your power and mercy. We ask this for the sake of Jesus Christ, in whom all our intercessions are acceptable, through the Spirit, and who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
with you.
Just that to encourage people, if they want to get a space for the flea market, there was a question of how big was the spaces, and if you notice in this week's announcement that it's a 12 by 12, that's what, how I came up with that, because nobody knew what spaces we had in the past. It was like we had no past flea market going on. But anyway, I came up with that because I found some little markings left over from the last time we had one, and I measured from one of those that seemed to have both sides, and I came up with the width of 12 feet. And then into the parking lot, I figured it would go 12 more feet. So that's where I came up with the 12 by 12, approximately, because some will be a little odder shape than others. So the first people on the list will probably get the best spots. And it's only because they were first on the list. We'll go down the list like that. And we've got, I think, 10... Only 10 people so far have reserved their space, and some people have said, "Oh, I'm coming. I'm going to have a space," but they have not filled out the application. So I encourage you to spread the word to fill out the application. That's all.
Thank you.
And I got that little thing about the fleas in the announcement.
Well, if there aren't any further announcements, walk in love as Christ loved us, offering himself a sacrifice to God.
Thank you. Thank you.
praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God.
Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be the holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, and in the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remembering your Lord, your one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ, reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. And grant that you may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with St. John and all the saints who found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them, and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father and God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
These are the gifts of God for you, the people of God. Body of Christ is broken for you.
precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries
that we are living members
of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.